Hello, and welcome to Architecture All Access, Season 3, Episode 1. I'm Tim Wilson, Vice President in the Design Engineering Group at Intel and a General Manager of SoC Design, where I have led the development of our revolutionary new client processor, Meteor Lake. I began my career as an analog circuit designer, leading the development of several IO5s on our past client processors, including Westmere, Haswell, and Broadwell. In the process, I accumulated 7 patents in analog circuit design. More recently, I've led a variety of projects spanning server and client segments, and I have experience building teams capable of executing complex SoC designs. This background has led me here, and it's been an exhilarating experience spearheading the development of what we consider an inflection point in SoC design and our largest shift in client SoC architecture in 40 years. In this season's intro, Max gave an overall introduction of Meteor Lake. If you haven't watched it yet, the link is in the description below. Today, we'll take a closer look at the details and decisions behind this architecture, including why we chose this moment to make such a major transition in our SoC development. As we explained earlier, our primary goals for Meteor Lake were to create the most power-efficient client processor we've ever built, introduce our first dedicated AI engine to usher in the AI PC era, and take a significant leap in graphics performance. Today, I'd like to step back and give you an all-access look into the guiding principles we've used to define and develop Meteor Lake, as well as an overview of the four-tile disaggregated architecture. The first principle in our next generation uncore for Meteor Lake is the concept of IP repartitioning. You can imagine that with over 100 IPs assembled in today's SoC chips, connecting and grouping them efficiently becomes crucial. To visualize this, think about designing the floor plan for a house, where decisions need to be made about the placement of each room for optimal living. For example, when the doorbell rings, you wouldn't want to walk through your newborn's bedroom to get to the front entryway. Similarly, in chip architecture, the placement of IPs is crucial for efficiency. For instance, in our client SoCs in the market today, the media IP is embedded inside the graphics block, which in turn is attached to our core complex and a high-performance ring fabric. Since graphics and media use the same ring fabric as the CPU cores to access cache and memory, the CPU core complex remains on if either graphics or media needs to access memory. This is a great architecture for performance, but for low-power use cases like media playback, a significant amount of logic remains on, and this presents an opportunity for power efficiency. In Meteor Lake, we separated the media and graphics blocks, and both are attached to the SoC fabrics independently from the core complex in the compute tile. Scalability and modularity were also key considerations. We needed to create a single floor plan that could support various configurations, just like planning a house for different family sizes. The architecture includes a new scalable fabric for high bandwidth connectivity, so now all the major blocks within the SoC can get full memory bandwidth when needed and remove the possibility of bottlenecks. Last, but certainly not least, we've implemented a low-power compute island, including 2 low-power E-cores integrated directly into the SoC tile. With this change, software can leverage these low-power E-cores for use cases like media playback and other low-power workloads that do not need the high compute performance of our E-cores and P-cores in the compute tile. Now let's talk about some of the other major architecture capabilities we added to Meteor Lake. First, we added a low-power AI engine, the Neural Processing Unit, or NPU, integrated right into the SoC to deliver new client AI experiences. This NPU will be ideal for low-power sustained AI workloads and will complement the AI functionality in our IA cores and our graphics IP. Working with industry partners like Microsoft and other ISVs, our new AI engine will allow us to deliver AI at scale and usher in a new era of AI PCs. Second, we made our first major extension of the hybrid architecture first introduced on Alder Lake. The new low-power E-cores, combined with the E-core and P-core in our compute tile, represent our new 3D performance hybrid architecture. Of paramount importance is our ability to properly schedule the right workload to the right core. To that effect, we enhanced our Intel Thread Director technology to properly coordinate with the OS for power efficiency and responsiveness. Don't miss Rajshree's episode coming up on our Thread Director technology and the major new enhancements we've made. With Meteor Lake, we set out to deliver a leap in graphics performance and power efficiency by leveraging the rich feature set and capabilities in our Arc discrete graphics, integrating them directly into the SoC to deliver a new design optimization point for graphics on Meteor Lake. It features 8 Xe cores with an advanced feature set, including support for DX12 Ultimate, hardware ray tracing, and XeSS AI-based upscaling. With this impressive 3D feature set, Meteor Lake delivers breakthrough performance at a low-power system design point. In the media engine, we also included support for the latest codecs, including AV1, key for reducing pixelation and enhancing visual quality. AV1 momentum continues to grow, including recent live streaming support from YouTube. Now, let's discuss the different approaches we considered when building the chip. Traditional monolithic construction, akin to building a house for a specific family, does not meet modularity and scalability requirements for today's SoCs. So instead, we adopted a disaggregated approach, creating separate functional units or tiles. Back to our house floor plan analogy, think of deciding what kind of flooring goes in which room. It makes sense to choose the type of flooring that matches the room. For example, tile in the bathroom, carpet in the bedroom, hardwood in the hallway. Similarly, when building chips, we can now choose the right type of transistors for the right tile. High performance for the CPU, high density for the GPU, low power for the SoC blocks, and stable process technology nodes with low leakage for I/O. Once we've made that decision, we need to find a way to connect the tiles together. Early in the design process, it became clear to us that many of the natural cut lines in our tiles were across high bandwidth interfaces. So it became paramount to choose a high bandwidth, low power, low latency interface to connect the tiles. The solution to these challenges is our advanced Foveros 3D packaging technology. Foveros offers the flexibility in scaling and reconfiguration. Tiles can easily be swapped, enabling Intel to adapt the chip's capabilities to different requirements. Foveros works on a microscopic scale, providing 36 micron pitch copper balls with exceptional precision. The result is a disaggregated architecture that delivers the performance of a monolithic design. All these new architecture capabilities deliver our most power-efficient client SoC ever, provide a leap forward in graphics performance, and will usher in the era of the AI PC. This is our most significant client SoC architecture shift in 40 years. Thanks for joining me today for Architecture All Access Meteor Lake. Stay tuned for the coming season 3 episodes in which we'll delve deeper into some of the tiles and driving technologies that make Meteor Lake a truly groundbreaking achievement.